You said we should backtrack and maybe insert this at an earlier point, but you were talking about the pedal changes being an element of difficulty here. Since this program is addressed to a general audience, would you like to explain what that is?
Yeah.
And why it's so hard?
Right, yeah.
And high heels?
Or even flat shoes. Yeah, the harp has, a lot of people don't know, has 47 strings, but 7 foot pedals as well. So the 47 strings are like the white keys on a keyboard, and the pedals, the 7 pedals, make the black keys or the sharps and flats. So there are 7 pedals, 1 for every note, A, B, C, D, E, F, G pedal, and each pedal has 3 notches, which can go from flat to natural or sharp. So every time that you want to change keys, you have to change pedals, one of these 7 pedals going from flat to natural or sharp or and back. So a piece that's very chromatic, that has a lot of chromatic writing, has a lot of footwork as well. And the mosaic piece especially is very challenging in that way because it does have a lot of chromatic writing and a lot of footwork.
Can you change 2 at the same time? I guess
occasionally you are required to change 2 at the same time. Usually it means that your left foot goes over to the 4 pedals that are on the right side of the harp, and so you change the 2 on the same side that way. Occasionally you have to change 2 on the same side. With 1 foot on the same side. I don't believe the mosaic piece is that involved. But the interesting thing also is most composers get very befuddled about writing for the harp because of the pedals. They don't understand the workings of the pedals or how to write for it. And Elliot Carter has definitely done his homework there. I don't know if he studied Salzedo's works that much or what, but everything, even though it's difficult, everything works. There are a lot of composers that write works that are not so difficult as far as the pedals or as far as fingering is concerned, and they just don't work. It's impossible to play some of the things that they write. In Elliot Carter's music, so far I found that everything is just about possible.
So back to the pedals. You don't want to make a mistake with your feet because that's going to sound like a mistake with your hands.
That's exactly right, yeah. You can be playing the right strings, and if the pedals are wrong, you're just in the wrong key. So it sounds like you're playing the wrong strings.
So that never happens to you.
Oh, of course not.
I didn't think so. Carter has been around a fair amount. I mean, you must have met him. What are your impressions about him as a person?
Well, I haven't met him to even do as much as have a conversation with him, but in the last couple of years, every time I would see him, he would say to me, "When are you ever going to play my piece?" And with this kind of, this work was commissioned by the BSO in collaboration with the Nash Ensemble of London. And the Nash Ensemble and their harpist performed it first. So that I know that it is a playable work.
Mm-hmm.
And finally, you know, I will get a chance to play it, and I'm sure that he will be happy to hear it.
There's something about his demeanor when he comes out for a curtain call that's very appealing. Would you describe that?
Yeah, he seems to be a very, very humble. He's not in any way seems extroverted or show-offy, you know. He just comes out as a very humble, thankful composer.
Mm-hmm. Have you heard a recording of this piece by the Nash Ensemble?
I have.
And what is your impression of the piece as a whole, leaving aside the problems of your own part in it?
Well, again, it's kind of the way I feel about a lot of contemporary music, and especially his music. When I first heard it, I thought, oh my goodness, what is this? And then the more I listened to it, the more I began to understand it and began to like it. So when I first heard it, I thought, this is impossible. I'll never be able to play this, or, you know, I don't even know if I want to, and, you know. But after a while, I'm especially now that I've started to work on it and started to put the hours in that are required for a piece like this. I'm really beginning to like it and to enjoy it.
Like how many hours?
By the time it's finished, it's going to be a lot of hours.
But you think it's definitely worth it.
Yes, exactly. And that's the main point, because there is a lot of music that's written that you put in a lot of hours, and at the end of the day, it's like, it's really not worth all that time spent. But in this piece, I mean, I know already, even though I haven't completed the process of learning it, I know that it's going to be worth it. This will actually be the first time I've had what I would call a solo experience with the TMC. I've been on the faculty there since 1981 and have just really enjoyed working with the fellows. I coach the chamber music works that include a harp part.
Mm-hmm.
And just the level of playing, it gets better every year, and it's been a great experience. But this will be the first time that I've done anything.
Gone on the stage with them.
So it's going to be very exciting. In a way, it'll be more fun than it would have been, say, to play with my BSO colleagues, because the younger players are so eager to play anything at all, and I think that they'll be very eager to play Elliot Carter's music.